Hello YouTube, this will be a not long video. Magnacut, where do I begin? First off, listen to what Larry Thomas says is the maker. Second, only trust in those who actually know what they are talking about and have tested good samples of magnacut. Any steel, no matter how super, and I'm doing this super because that is a layman term in my eyes. There is nothing super about steels, they all do different things well. But so-called super steels, they can suck too if they are not heat treated properly. Don't have the proper geometry to support it, if they are burnt at the edge when making them, etc. etc. So please, if you have got bad experience with magnacut, don't take that as magnacut is bad. Because when magnacut is good, trust me, it's very good. I have two examples. I have an outdoor blade here, my own design. Aaron Johnson made it. He hasn't got the HRC tester, but he uses some files, HRC testing files that isn't completely accurate, but it gives you a ballpark. We're 99% sure, say 95%, yeah. They're pretty sure that this is 62.8, 63, 63.2, around there. It's very hard. It has amazing edge stability. It's pretty thin at the edge. I don't know how well that picks up, but I banged this into a 2x4, and yeah. I've used this for, is it, yeah, it's actually over 5 months. I must think, yeah, a little over 5 months without sharpening it, just stropping it. I've cut lots of cardboard. I've cut not rope, a little, but not anything significant. I've cut that plastic cardboard, no, plastic foam shitty thing on my channel. I've banged it into a 2x4. I've taken it into the woods. It's still very sharp. I'm doing this slow to see if there are any snags. And I just stropped it quick after use. And yeah, not a fault in the edge. For outdoor blade, 62.5, 63. If you aren't batoning it like crazy, it's perfect. My chef knife, it's HRC 64. It's extremely thin, as you can see. It's sharp. The outdoor knife is 15 degrees per side, like many chef knives are. Again, you decide the angle. You can have a chef knife at 20-25, which is more than a felling axe. And I get mad when people say, well, it keeps its edge longer. No. Edge retention is all about lowering the angle. So this is 5 to 8-ish per side, probably 5. It's as low as it can go. I can't go lower. You can see it's taking the finish off. So I can't go any lower. There are no micro bevel here. It's as low as it can go. I've used this, I shop with it. I don't abuse my knives. I use them hard, But there's a difference between using a knife hard as a tool and abusing it. I don't do this on this ceramic, I don't cut on marble or bamboo. I use these hard plastic. I do like rocking, I do chopping. I don't do this, I don't scrape the edge. I'm just a little stupid, but not full-blown stupid. The only thing I've had, I can actually see it in the light, it's... Yeah, I need to like put it into my eyes. It's not a tenth of a millimeter. You can strop it out if you want to. But the tiniest chip. I mean, it's so tiny, 99% of people won't even see it with their eyes. And that was hitting bone. I was cleaning. I can't remember if it's pork or beef. I said beef, then pork. I can't remember. But imagine I cut the sinew. I'm using the spine here, went along the bone. And suddenly the bone went a little curved up, and I hit that. But the chip is so damn minimal that you won't even notice it. So yeah, I'm doing this as shallow as I can. Nothing there. The chip is over at the belly part there. I could feel it, but that's going extremely slow. I can barely feel it. If I do normal speed, there's nothing there. You don't feel it when cutting either. The tip on this, it's just insane. I don't know if you can. I've done it earlier, doing a circle. There, I barely got it, as you see. It's a crappy circle, but hey, it's extremely sharp. Magnacut can take the most amazing edge. I would put the edge taking, how clean of an edge Magnacut can take. With the best carbon out there, like a gummy super or even white steel, you can get a just as low angle edge and as fine edge on Magnacut that you can on white steel. But Magnacut keeps it a whole shit ton longer, that's for sure. I haven't got anything bad to say about Magnacut. Not one thing. It's insanely stainless. It blows my mind how stainless it is. It's literally so stainless. If you get it to rust, you abuse your knives. Simple as that. I've tested this. My outer blades out by the sea, dipping it in the salt water, letting it stay for 10-20 minutes, etc. Just rinsing it off with fresh water, wiping it dry. Not a single spot, not brown, not red, nor anything. I've used it, the chef knife, on the most sour ingredients like lemon, etc. Nothing. In a kitchen, that's a huge ass plus. By the sea, by outdoors, huge ass plus. Then let's talk about toughness. I've beaten that 63 knife the crap out of it in a 2x4. I torqued the edge, I pried with the tip, no damage. I've used it on a probably 40 50 big boxes, like say 20 inches by 20 inches, big ass boxes. as big as my upper torso boxes, 40-50 of those. I cut shit ton of that plastic with the, no, the, sorry, the foam with the glued in plastic insert. I've used it on wood, I've betoned, I've done everything I can with that outer knife. It's still perfectly sharp. No, it won't whittle fucking hair. It won't shave your beard or ass hair, but fucking hell, stop talking about that stupid nonsense. It will carve wood all day long. It will do cardboard. It will cut whatever the hell it needs to cut. It will slice a tomato, onion, potato, meat. It's the same with the chef knife. It keeps its edge so fuckingly good. I've never had a steel as good as magnacut. Never. I've had some steels that are very close. Nylox is one when very good heat treated from Patrick. It's superb. ABL from Patrick Kalvik. Superb. Let me think. I've had M4 in a Spyderco Gale Bradley. That was also extremely good. But how do I put it? Take in consideration, my English isn't as good. All these steels are good at something. This is good at everything. It's not the best in stainless, but it's probably in the top 3. In toughness, in stainless steels, it's probably in the top 3. In the edge holding, and here is one thing people don't understand. Because the so-called super edge holding steels, you can't sharpen it as low as thin as you can magnacut. I may be wrong, I haven't tested it. So I may be wrong, and then if I am wrong, I say sorry now before the comments start. But this can be thin. I would much rather have magnacut in all my knives than Rex 121 or S90V, 15V, 10V, etc. It's extremely good. But John at BGM Knives, not your average EDC, etc., have had some bad experiences with it. That doesn't say the steel is bad. I've gotten bad S35 VN knives that, yeah, they just crumbled. It was like the cheapest Victorinox pocket knife when you used it. It's first off, if steels are good heat treated, done as good as they can for its purpose, damn, 440C is a great steel. 154, yeah. 3V, for example, is a steel that is way overrated. 3V can't take a very thin edge and hold it. I don't care what the fuck you say. Try it. Try taking a 3V knife down to 5-8 degrees per side and let's see what happens. There's toughness, which to me means lateral toughness. Just if I beton it, how much can it bend and take that way. Then you have impact toughness, which if I take something and hit the edge or etc. Then you have edge stability. How thin and low angle you can have on the edge without it chipping or rolling. And that's where magnacut shines to me. It's crazy how thin I can take magnacut. It's very near 8678 CRV2 and good carbon steels. Very, very near. The chef knife is there. The outdoor isn't fully there. It's maybe 20-25% from being as thin as I can take 8670, but 8670 is so crazy tough, and edge stability, it's insane. But the wear resistance in that steel is very, very, very low comparing magnacut. But in a chopper, why would you care about wear resistance? I would much rather have the toughness of 8670. But in an outdoor blade like that, which is mixed use, magnacut is the way to go. Chef knife, magnacut is the way to go. I've never had a kitchen steel I liked so much. So, take all I said with a grain of salt. Do your own testing, but if you're gonna test magnacut, do it with good magnacut. Not crappy heat treated or with edge overheated by grinding, etc, etc. If you are gonna test something, test a good version of that. If you're gonna test S30V, test S30V when it's good heat treated, good grinded, etc. It's the same with all steels. Thanks for watching. Sorry for swearing. I love you all. Please press like, leave a comment, share the channel. Bye.